The Norman Priory Church of Saint Swithun lies at the heart of Leonard Stanley in Gloucestershire. A great fire 20 years after the Great Fire of London destroyed the market house and many buildings, but the church was left unscathed. In the Middle Ages, the village was a thriving market town. Today, it is a quiet and friendly village. Cheese and cider were noted products in the 18th century, and the woolen industry is recorded as early as the 14th century, when the village bustled with weaving shops and wool stores. To the east and west of the church are farms. Church Farm was built in 1688 by John Sanford. Owl holes in the outer walls are said to allow the passage of owls to eat mice, which could damage the bales of wool stored in the attic. Built as a weaver's cottage around 1600, Ivy Cottage has the only spiral stone staircase left in the village. The tannery was built in 1770 by James Clutterbuck, the surgeon. It ceased production in 1940. From the time of Edward II, there were two fairs held annually in the village, one at Swithuntide for pedlary, and the other on the Feast of St. Leonard for livestock. This year the village celebrates the 850th anniversary of the consecration of its beautiful Norman church, and the highlight of the celebrations is the revival of the St. Swithuns Fair. Hundreds of folks from far and near have converged on this quiet corner of Gloucestershire, many in medieval costume, recapturing the atmosphere of a country fair long forgotten. The Norman church was consecrated in 1129, probably on St. Swithun's Day. It was built as part of an Augustinian priory by Roger de Berkeley II, but after his death, his cousin William gave the priory of Stanley St. Leonard's to the monks of St. Peter's Abbey at Gloucester. Hence it became a house of the Benedictine order for the next 400 years. On August 6, 1535, the king with his new bride Anne Boleyn visited the priory. It was during their happy days spent at Prinich, Painswick and Berkeley, and a few months before Queen Elizabeth was born. Truly a notable event, and only 3 years before the king ordered William, the last abbot of Gloucester, to recall his monks from Leonard Stanley, and to grant the priory and its endowments on lease of 99 years to Sir William Kingston. 4 months later, the abbey itself was dissolved. Today, that royal visit is reenacted. Our national history is closely linked with Normandy, Leonard Stanley especially so, as the priory is one of the finest examples of mid-Norman architecture in England. Since 1970, Leonard Stanley has been twinned with the French village of Dozule in Normandy. In honour of the 850th celebrations, the Dozule Fire Brigade Band, led by Monsieur Georges Proté, make their entry. The climax of the festivities was yet to come, when on the Sunday the village remembered its patron saint, Blessed Swithun. The Lord Bishop of Gloucester, president of the festival, his archdeacon, and the Prior of Prynash shared in celebrating the Eucharist, a service performed throughout 850 years in Leonard Stanley. So ended, in fair and prayer, a most memorable 2 days of celebrations.